Have you ever looked at the price of something at the store and wondered, what's really going on behind that number? Well, today we're going to dig into the economic chain reaction that kicks off the moment a government decides to subsidize a product.
I mean, it sounds kind of weird when you think about it, right? Why would the government step in and basically pay part of your grocery bill? It actually happens all the time, especially with essential goods, and the reasons and the results are super interesting.
Okay, so to really get what changes, we first need to see what a normal market looks like before anyone messes with it. We need a before picture.
All right, so here's your classic setup. You've got the supply curve, that's how much companies are willing to sell, and the demand curve, that's how much we all want to buy. Where those two lines cross, that's the sweet spot. We call it equilibrium. It's the price and quantity that the market just naturally agrees on.
But now, into this perfectly balanced little world, a new player enters the game. The government decides it wants to shake things up.
And the tool they use is called a subsidy. Now, here's the really crucial part. This isn't just a big check they hand over. It is a specific payment that a producer gets for every single item they sell.
And you know, the motivation is usually pretty solid. They're looking at things we all need, like bread or milk, and they're trying to bring that price tag down to make those necessities just a little bit more affordable for everybody.
So the government puts the money on the table, but how does that actually change what people do? To see that, let's step into the shoes of a producer for a second.
So let's say you're a baker. The government tells you, hey, for every loaf of bread you sell, we'll slip you a dollar. Now, from your perspective, it feels like your costs, the flour, the energy, all of it, just got a dollar cheaper for every single loaf. You're suddenly making more money on each one.
And this is where the whole picture starts to change. Because it now feels cheaper for producers to make their product, they are totally willing to supply more of it at any price. On our graph, this literally shoves the entire supply curve outwards to the right.
So with that new supply curve locked in, the old balance is completely out the window. The market now has to find a new resting point, a new equilibrio. And check out what happens. That new intersection point between demand and our new shifted supply curve, it lands at a much higher quantity. So the very first result is simple. More stuff is being sold. More bread is being baked, bought, and eaten than ever before.
But here's where it gets really, really interesting. The price actually splits in two. You, the consumer, you walk into the store and you pay a new lower price. Awesome. But at the same time, the producer is getting that lower price from you plus the subsidy from the government. So the total amount they receive is actually higher than before.
And that gap, that little bit of air between the price the producer gets and the price you pay, it's not some random number. It is exactly the amount of the subsidy. It's that $1 per loaf we were just talking about.
Okay, so let's zoom out and do a final tally. Let's see how this whole thing nuts out for everybody involved.
All right, let's just recap the highlights. Consumers get a cheaper price, producers get to take home more money, and overall, more of the product is being bought and sold. I mean, on the surface, that sounds like a win-win-win, right?
But of course, that money doesn't just materialize out of thin air. There's a bill. And the total cost to the government is pretty simple math. You just take that new, higher number of items being sold and multiply it by the subsidy for each one. That final number is the total tab that, one way or another, taxpayers have to cover.
Which, of course, brings us to the real million-dollar question. The subsidy worked, no doubt about it. The price on the shelf is lower, and there's more of it to go around. But it's not magic. It introduces a cost that's paid by everyone through taxes. It's just rearranging the money on the board. So the question isn't just if it works, it's who is really paying the price.